So good afternoon, all of you. Please respond. I think I am audible to all of you.
Yes, sir. Okay. Sir. Yeah. Good afternoon, participants. Welcome to this online webinar series for Appendix 3 and LDCE. Today's topic is store suspense accounts expenditure control. To take this topic, we have faculty Sri P.V. Raghavan Garu, presently working as faculty at TDFM. Sir, welcome, sir. Please, over to you.
Thank you, Nageswara, to participate in this session. I am very happy to be with you all. Today, we will discuss about these stores accounts, and the stores accounts may most important aspects with regard to operation of suspense accounts, various kinds of suspense accounts, and also at the end of this session, the expenditure control part, a little part about the expenditure control, how, what are the various avenues to exercise control over expenditure while dealing with these stores accounts transactions in our internet check, hamara internet check bare mein. And at the end, may aapko one word answer questions bhi diya hai, main aap khud answer karke pehle answer ki bhi diya hai main at the end of this thing, aap a verify kar sakte. So welcome all of you to this session. Very happy to be with you in this afternoon. Good afternoon, Amit Kumar ji, thank you very much for that. Today we will be going to the introducing you to stores accounts. Stores accounts, I will give some introduction part with reference to hamara stores accounts ki branch ki bare mein. Indian Railways being a itna bada organization hai, transport organization, it has to have some kind of control or expenditure mechanism in the various parts of our expenditure. The expenditure being like revenue expenditure, capital expenditure, and the expenditure related to the inventory consumption, and expenditure related to the labor cost, and these are the various element-wise cost control concepts of our accounting functions.
Like sir, I'm present in the presentation mode, sir, PPT.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, now right. Okay, sir.
So the stores procured are normally, they are known as stores in stock. Stores in stock, as the name suggests, it is a real account. Our accounting principles hai, double entry bookkeeping principle. It's a real account ka closing stock account. Kaise hum mante, it is our asset. It is an asset. Indian Railways inventories are also assets. But anyway, but it is a different way. In a different way, we treat them as assets. That's why they, because the consumption pattern, and the procurement of material for the zonal railways as well as the production units is so huge. Na bada hai. So we have to have a proper control over expenditure mechanism with regard to procurement, storage issue, our balances ka bare mein. Continuous issue hona chahiye. Isiliye we have to have a proper system. So the most important part of this capital expenditure mode of railway accounting, stores accounting, the purpose is to have a most economical procurement of stores, by combining the various inputs, and efficient use of material required for the activities. And also they is aisa karna hai, hum just in time we have to supply the material to the activities, so that the activity should be continuous, and activity should not be hampered, and it should give highest service level, achieve karna hai. As such, the stores department is responsible for this. As such, we have a PHOD known as principal chief material manager. He is the head of the stores organization who will handle the procurement and issue of stores in general. Principal chief material manager is the head of the stores organization. He is a principal HOD. He is responsible for procurement and issue of materials in the general railways, and also as well in the production units, and also to see that the balance part of these components, issue material, should be as minimum as possible, not to hold up the capital, that is cash part of our account. As a receipt of material at depots is initially, because when I say stores depots, it is meant for stocking. All the items that are maintained in depots are known as stock items. All the items maintained at various stores, depots under the control of the PCMM available in a general railway are known as stock items. And then from these stock depots, various consuming departments, whenever they are there, they will be drawing. Various consignees of the same department, various consignees of the same department, also other departments also, they may be drawing the material for their regular activities. Since the material is drawn, whenever I draw the material, I use an activity, normally there exists a final allocation, that is known as final head. Whenever I draw the material and consume on an activity, it is known as charging the expenditure to the activity, that is a final head. A final head, it may be a final head related to a planned expenditure, a final head may be related to a revenue expenditure. It is a behavior of ICDA, but component may be the same. But item which is given and used to the consignee for his activity, it may be a revenue expenditure of different consignees, it may be capital expenditure of different consignees, or so many. So that means we need to have a common pool, that is known as a suspense account. A suspense account used to be required to be operated. That is known as stores in stock account. Normally, all the balances of stores are made available in a account, a suspense account known as stores in stock account. The name of the name of this stores in stock account is responsible for recording the transactions relating to the procurement and also issue of the items in a stores. Oh, that is the important item. So the operation of suspense account for such kind of issues and receipts is inevitable and is necessary. So we operate a suspense account. This account name is maintained under the plan head 7100. The source fund is capital. It is a capital suspense account. Capital suspense account under P7100 is plan head, P is capital, the source fund. When I will say plan head, always all plan heads are identified with a source fund, we are all aware. CLA, our source in stock account, again, assisted by various other suspense accounts known as purchase suspense account, sales suspense account, stores in transit account, and stock adjustment account. Aur ek baar main bataunga. The stores in stock account again assisted with the other suspense accounts known as purchase suspense account, sales suspense account, stores in transit account, and stock adjustment account. So pura a suspense outstanding items ka dekh sakte hum, a bada stores in stock item hai, stores in stock account P7100. So Indian Railways inventories are available under P7100. 7200 and 7300. P means capital source fund, 7100 source in stock account, 7200 workshop manufacturing suspense account, 7300 miscellaneous advances capital account. If you know, like a hum inventories, Indian Railways ka inventory samajhte. So, aage jayenge, hamara classification of stores ka bare mein ek thoda jankari lenge. Stores are broadly divided into stock and non-stock items. Stores are broadly divided into stock items and non-stock items. Stock items are again further divided into two tarikas. Ek is ordinary stores, other one is emergency stores. Please remember, again, please note down. All of you put a small pen and paper so that you can write, jot down. So we did not maintain the record. Just simply record it for your remembrance. So stock items are further divided into ordinary stores and emergency stores. Ordinary stores bare mein kya hai? The ordinary stores are, they are regular in use, they are caused by regular demand, and they are to be stocked by the stores department in depots. Whereas emergency stores comprising of items which do not ordinarily wear out, they don't wear out or require renewal, but have to be kept in stock to meet emergencies, and items which are not normally such kind of items are not readily available in the with the source, not available in the market. As such, hum jaruri ye procure karke rakhna hai emergency stores ki bare mein. So emergency stores hota hai. Isliye dono items known as stock items, which are stocked for the purpose of emergency requirement. Or ek cheez hai non-stock items. Non-stock items are stores other than the stores and emergency stores. So non-stock items are the stores. They are not other than ordinary stores, other than emergency stores. They are known as non-stock items. They are not purchased for the stocking purposes. They are not purchased for the stocking purposes. They are directly purchased by the executive departments and charged out to the final heads there and then. Non-stock items are not meant for stocking. They are purchased by the regular executive departments within their purchase powers, and they are not maintained in the depots, and they are finally charged after the final heads whenever they are used. Means stock items are first charged after the stores in stock account, whereas non-stock items are directly charge to the final heads, because हमारा non-stock item का identify कर सकते किस activity में use किया जाए. इसीलिए non-stock items are under the powers of executive authorities. हमारा they are within the powers of the executive authorities. और एक चीज़ है special stores. Special stores means they are not for the operations and also not for the ordinary repairs and maintenance. But however, stores department only procure these items. These special stores are procured by the stores department, but however, without stocking them, we will give it to the end user. We will give it to the user department. That is the importance of the special store. So stores ke bare mein kya dekha hum? Stock items, non-stock items. Stock items are further divided into ordinary stores and emergency stores, and non-stock items are not for the purpose of stocking and for the purpose of purchasing the items, wherever we can directly charge it to the activities, duly debiting to the final heads. So non-stock items are dealt under non-stock indents, whereas stock items are dealt under the annual indents. Annual, because non-stock items then and there, item wise, whereas stock indents are on the annual indents. That is the importance of classification of stores. Aur ek cheez hum bataunga aapko. आइटम्स स्टोर्स सरप्लस स्टोर्स के बारे में क्या है ये सरप्लस स्टोर्स हमारा एग्जाम में आता है इसलिए दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट आइटम्स ऑफ स्टोर्स व्हिच हैव नॉट बीन इश्यूड फ्रॉम स्टॉक आइटम्स ऑफ स्टोर्स व्हिच हैव नॉट बीन इश्यूड फॉर कंजम्पशन फॉर ए पीरियड ऑफ 24 मंथ्स दो साल 24 मंथ्स ड्यू टू ऑब्सोलेसेंस चेंज इन डिजाइन और स्पेसिफिकेशन unanticipated fall in consumption which had not been possible to avoid such as by smaller purchases unanticipated fall in consumption which it had not been possible to avoid such as by smaller purchases under the system of annual contracts return of large quantity of stores by the user department under surplus stores surplus aaya so wapas hi aa raha hai then these are known as surplus stores normally these are all known as surplus hamara again surplus stores are again classified into two categories surplus stores are categorized into two again categorized into two varieties that is movable surplus and dead surplus what is movable surplus items of stores which have not been issued for a period of 24 months items of stores which have not been issued for a period of 24 months but for which it is anticipated iska upyog hai isliye hum maintain kar sakte hain So we anticipate that these will be utilized in the near future are known as movable surplus. So surplus hai, but lekin ye move kar sakte hamara department mein koi other concerns mein, other railways mein, other divisions mein. So that is known as movable surplus. Whereas the dead surplus, there is another item is known as dead surplus. This dead surplus items of stores which are not issued for 24 months, if they are not issued for the last 24 months and also not likely to be utilized anywhere in the railways not likely to be utilized anywhere in the railways because of the withdrawal of design it has become useless that item is no more useful for the Indian Railways that is known as dead surplus so disposal of dead surplus is arranged through these various ways hum use try karna hai transfer karna hai pehle or finally we have to sell it outside through a survey committee we have to sell them off through an auction because we have to realize some scrap value out of those dead surplus items. Normally, whenever we found that some of the items are surplus or dead stock, the dead stock item use the formula as dead stock item DSA item number 8, and we dispose it of accordingly accounting that. So, for the purpose of stores accounts and for the purpose of accounts control, normally we have nomenclature of the stores of each item. आपको बता रहा हूँ मैं, stores items are many, they are stock and stock depots, and overall in charge of the stock items is the principal chief material manager. These stock items are maintained in the stock depots. There is a depot in charge officer. But for identification and standardization के लिए each item, हर item, carriage items, wagon items, loco items, ascent items, electrical items, OH items, general electrical items, like that we have a classification. We have a group wise classification of list. Accordingly, हमारे पास है एक nomenclature list है, एक price list है, which is known as price list. So each item is identified with a number, price list number. That is price, in a price ledger we will be maintaining a price list number. Each item of stores in stock is assigned a separate number, each item with a specification, a separate number दिया जाता है, as well as full description is required, because this item with this specification, with the description, with this number used for the requisition, that is indenting, then receipt, that is procurement while placing the purchase order, and issue while issuing the item to the consignees for the activities, and maintenance and other documents, other managerial purpose. So we need to have a, it is so important to have expenditure control over the usage of items for the various activities. हमारा रेलवे में ये जरूरत है, हर आइटम एक नॉमेनक्लेचर होना चाहिए और प्राइस लिस्ट होना चाहिए, प्राइस लिस्ट नंबर, प्राइस लेजर नंबर, रियल नंबर होना चाहिए. व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस? दिस इज टू फैसिलिटेट द यूजर डिपार्टमेंट्स एंड फाइनेंस डिपार्टमेंट आल्सो. हमारा फाइनेंस डिपार्टमेंट और अकाउंट का डिपार्टमेंट अकाउंट करने के लिए फॉर प्रॉपर प्रोक्यूरमेंट कंसम्पशन एंड अकाउंट ऑफ आइटम्स इन सच ए वे that we don't procure in excess of the requirement. Normally, the purpose of maintaining this kind of standardization is to have, not to have an excess procurement than the occasion requires. Because if we, what is total value of the requirement for the entire annum, इसी मुताबिक हम procure करना है और इसी मुताबिक issue करना होगा, क्योंकि हमारे पास थोड़ा buffer होना चाहिए for regular use issue of material. So the objects of the maintenance of price list is to ensure standardization होना चाहिए, standardized करने के लिए, and to avoid fancy procurement, to issue material on up to date. While issuing the item to an activity, we have to apply a rate which is an updated rate. कैसा होता है? ये price ledger में एक proforma है, इसमें book average rate बनता है. बुक एवरेज रेट प्राइस लेजर का जरूर आवश्यक क्या है बोले तो इट इज टू मेक ए बुक एवरेज रेट अपडेट द रेट बेस्ड ऑन द लेटेस्ट परचेज एंड अकॉर्डिंगली व्हेनेवर यू इशू द मटेरियल टू द एक्टिविटी दैट एक्टिविटी इज चार्ज्ड ऑफ बेस्ड ऑन द बुक एवरेज रेट दैट इज अपडेटेड रेट. इसीलिए हर आइटम का, हर स्टॉक आइटम्स का एक प्राइस लेजर लिस्ट, प्राइस लिस्ट नॉमेनक्लेचर दिया जाता है. Also, this will facilitate the speedy supply of stores by the depots and also the systematic maintenance of ledgers. So, our issue, receipt issue and balance होना चाहिए. इसलिए हम पूरा मैनेजरल जानकारी लेना चाहिए. इसलिए to facilitate speedy supply, we need this nomenclature price list. Also, to facilitate the finance department check the reasonableness of the rates, check the reasonableness of rates as well as the quantities in the annual estimates. The importance of having this price list and nomenclature is to see that we have to have the reasonableness of the rates for the procurement in future, as well to have the quantities to be provided in the annual estimates to be so reasonable, so requirements, so standardized, so there should not be any item which is not required is procured. Item which is not required for the activity is procured, is to ensure that. So the importance of this price ledger is that. So normally these items, I want a chart. What is that? So book average rate, there is a question for me. Again, I will repeat book average rate. Book average rate is a rate that is arrived at in the price ledger, in the price ledger where the each items book average rate is updated. Hamara book average rate is update hota hai har receipt ki bare mein. For example, January mein ek receipt aaya 100 rupees bata di. February mein 110 mein aaya ek item. And April में 120 में है, इसका एवरेज बना के तीनों आइटम्स का एवरेज बना के टोटल वैल्यू ऑफ द आइटम्स प्रोक्यूर्ड टू एंड ऑफ लास्ट रिसीप्ट डिवाइडेड बाय क्वांटिटी अवेलेबल इन दैट पर्टिकुलर स्टॉक इज नथिंग बट बुक एवरेज रेट. और एक बार बताऊंगा, द टोटल वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रोक्यूरमेंट ऑफ द वेरियस आइटम दैट पर्टिकुलर आइटम अंडर वेरियस डेट्स इज divided by the total quantity available in the price ledger is the book average rate, latest book average. इसी मुताबिक हम issue करेंगे. इसीलिए हमारा हर accounting में some concerns will charge based on the last in first out, पुराना rate और last in first out, first issue में last rate, then first in first out, first item the first rate. ऐसा हमारा रेलवे का प्रिंसिपल क्या है बोले तो स्टैंडर्ड प्रोसीजर स्टैंडर्ड रूल इज दैट वी हैव टू अराइव एट ए वेटेड बुक एवरेज रेट. बुक एवरेज रेट इज नथिंग बट द टोटल वैल्यू ऑफ द आइटम अवेलेबल इन द प्राइस लेजर एट द डेट डिवाइडेड बाय द क्वांटिटी ऑन दैट डेट इज नथिंग बट बुक एवरेज रेट. व्हेन आई एम इश्यूइंग दैट आइटम टू ए एक्टिविटी, so that activity is charged with the book average rate, not with reference to the latest purchase rate or the old purchase rate. Aisa nahi hai, isliye it is important. So this means our railways activities are charged based on the some kind of realistic value. So nothing is either overcharged nor undercharged. Isliye we will be charging the activities based on the updated book average rate. This is the most important. So and also this is also to facilitate speedy procurement of items by the stores, and also maintain ledgers, and also to see the balances, inventory balance, item wise depot balances, entire depot wise, entire zonal railway balances, as well Indian Railways balance against that each item, so that we will have a control over expenditure mechanism. This is most important requirement for the purpose of control over expenditure in Indian Railways for the consumption and procurement of material required for the activities of Indian Railways. So for the purpose of maintenance and distribution, the stores are divided into, so hum kya karenge, the general stores and engineering stores. Engineering stores means PVA stores, permanent wear stores. The system of maintaining the records and charging up the job is the same way. But however, the general stores are under the control of principal chief material manager stores depots, whereas engineering stores are maintained by the engineering department. Please remember again, aur ek baar repeat karunga, hamara PVA stores ka रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है मेंटेन करने के लिए, और इसके बारे में रिकॉर्ड्स मेंटेन करें, इट इज द रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट टू मेंटेन द पीवे मटेरियल डिपोज. इज द रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द, बिकॉज़ दे विल बी दे आर दे ट्रैक इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट आइटम एंड हैज टू बी मेंटेन्ड बाय देम ओनली बिकॉज़ देयर एक्सपर्टाइज इज रिक्वायर्ड. दैट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ हैविंग ए प्राइस लिस्ट एंड नॉमिनलेचर प्राइस लेजर नंबर एंड आल्सो हैविंग ईच प्राइस लेजर हैविंग ए book average rate, getting up to date from time to time. This is for the purpose of standardization and avoid fancy procurement, and also to ensure some kind of required control over expenditure mechanism, which is necessary for the purpose of having the procurement and having balance reasonably without any excess procurement. That is the importance of having this thing. So now I will give you thoda definition mein de dunga very quickly. First thing is funds register. So what are the tools hamare paas, kya hai stores accounts mein for the purpose of these things. I will give you small definitions. A funds register, this is the most important register. It is maintained in the stores accounts department. It is maintained group wise items in which because each material material manager attached to the interest register, this PCME, it is PCMM. Please Sanjo, it is PCMM, sorry, my correct karunga. PCMM attached to principal material manager office. PCMM maintenance, it is maintaining the stores accounts officer. So again, it's the budget grant made in that particular year for each group of stores. For each group of stores, I will be entering into the indents cumulatively and also purchase orders cumulatively in such a way that during the year, the procurement authority should not exceed the budget grant. The purpose of the maintaining the funds registered in the stores accounts office is to see that all the indents and purchase orders are placed in this recorded in the funds register, to see that at any point of time, the liability made against the railways is not in excess of the budget grant made available for that year. Budget grant made available for that year. This is the most important. This is a better tool for the control or expenditure mechanism. Before incurring the liability itself, this is important. Then having limited tender system. One small, small definitions I give you. I give only few only. Aap thoda stores code refer karke. Mai thoda de dunga. Limited tender system is for the getting the work, getting the supplies from the approved list of the contract. That means except in the case of procurement of safety items. These items which are in regular demand, which are in regular usage, wherever the specification is given. So these to be procured from the approved list maintained and approved list given by the respective centralized agency like RDSO, production units, core Allahabad. So central organization for railway electrification, prime production units like ICF, RCF, BLW, like that, DMW. So many, so they give specification for the components that are required for the purpose of procurement and maintenance of these rolling stock according to the design, according to the design specifications. So this limited tender system is for the procurement of items through the approved list maintained, wherein this approved list vendor is issued by some centralized agency, will make any production unit, anything can be issued. So from the, that is known as the limited tender system. So procurement, other than emergency cases, which we make purchase orders based on the approved list of the suppliers, is known as limited tender system. There is another term known as bulletin tender. Normally, this is for repeated small items. Normally, depot officers will maintain it, issue a bulletin tender. This may be a weekly bulletin tender, maybe a fortnightly bulletin tender. Whenever requirement is there, maybe there may be occasions, weekly twice or thrice, maybe ho sakta hai. This is known as bulletin tender. So approved contractors of the small items in their list, wherever maintained in the depot, they can send their quotations with reference to items published in the bulletin, so that the stores department and accounts department will verify, scrutinize those bulletin tender offers and fix the rates for the purpose of speedy procurement of regular items. This is known as bulletin tender. Lump sum contract. Kya hai? Under this, the contractor engages to carry out a work or effect supply as specified and within given period for a fixed total sum. It is for that particular total sum, maybe 3 crores, maybe 4 crores, maybe 5 crores, maybe a total lump sum in which payment being dependent on his completing the work or supply to specification and time, irrespective of the actual quantities and kinds of work done or material supplied in achieving his. Finally, the quantity is not fixed, however, within that value that the purchaser make requisition the supplier to give the supply the items within that total value, that is known as lump sum contracts. Then normally in Indian railway systems, we have a open tender system in which the system of invitation to tender by public advertisement in the most open and public manner. Aur ek baar repeat karunga main, the open tender system is invitation of tender by public advertisement in the most open and public manner possible, that is most transparent way. As a rule, it should be, we have to float only open tenders for the procurement of items which are for the expenditure which is made from the government, the consolidated fund of India, that is public money. So items, but however, there are certain exceptions for the limited tenders. Items having values beyond direct purchase powers, wherever requirement is the direct purchase power, some items which are not in higher demand, higher quantity names, but however, there is the powers of direct purchase powers of the source officers. Yes, up to 50 lakhs they can buy. Or 2 crores in the case of emergencies, or 2 crores in the case of procurement of safety items and procurement of items whose approved list of vendors is issued by centralized approving agencies like RDSO, production units and core, etc. So whenever there is an item which is to be procured from the approved list of the contract, approved list of the suppliers, then except that item has to be procured through approved list only for the purpose of safety. Whenever there is involvement of safety is there, safety of item, because this is most important. So otherwise, all items are through open tenders only. Open tender means it is invitation to tender by public advertisement in the most open and public manner, most open and public manner, which is a transparent exercise. That is known as open tender. Another term I will give you, another delivery contract. This is known as, this is for the definite quantity of materials to be delivered on a definite date. So, itna jarurat hai, by that date, we have to have that item available with us for our activities. That is known as, otherwise we will not take up the contract. That is known as delivery contract. Normally, items which can be planned, in the annual index, annual contract mode, is not dealt under this type of contract, or not annual contract items which can be planned are not dealt under this mode of contract. The only important materials not placed on annual index, are like some metals, copper, zinc, wagera, where we can have big fluctuations so that we can procure the raw material of that particular item and can get, that is known as delivery contract, that is known as delivery contract. There is another term known in stores accounts, we see price preference. Because in stores procurement, we have Make in India policy, encouraging the small and micro enterprises, micro, small and medium enterprises like that. So we have various obligations on the part of the government of India to procure the items, to encourage the development of industries in the country and develop sources around the requirement in a zonal railway. So this policy has been laid and given. So this includes purchase of items from public sector units and also small scale industries, medium enterprises under Make in India policy items. So this is regulated by the government of India from time to time. Price preference will be kya hai? The items which are within the range of price preference, that is maybe within 15%, maybe 10%, within that price preference, if any person of the indigenous manufacturer offering a rate within the L1 plus 15 or L1 plus 10%, as the case may be, if it is, so we will take from, we will give a offer to the MSME and SME entrepreneur to supply the items at the L1 rate, at the lowest rate only, not their rate, but only in the case of price preference, we will be giving, in a way, we will be offering the quantity to that particular MSME supplier so that we can develop a source within the vicinity, which can be a competitor and can have a competitive rate in future contract. That is developing a source, it's part of a developing a source, is the Make in India policy guidelines. That is the most important thing. Price preference is to encourage the development of industries of the country within certain limit, maybe 15% relevance for the purchase of articles manufactured or produced in India. That is, MSME supplier can give up to, he has quoted 115 rupees, whereas L1 has quoted 100 rupees. So some quantity at the L1 rate can be offered to the MSME supplier. So that is known as price preference clause. These clauses are made in the stores contracts. Please remember, this is an important clause. Then what is a purchase order? A small item. unit examination point of view. This is an order form issued by stores officer to a supplier on the authority of which the firms arrange to supply the materials. In this, we have various details with reference to description of the item, wanted to be supplied, weight, unit of item, total value payable, inclusive of taxes or exclusive of taxes, other payment terms, when it is to be paid, where it is to be delivered, number and date of the order. So, pura details is made, purchase order made. It is an order placed on the supplier to supply the items at a particular date, at a particular place, so that the transaction is completed. So it should be so unambiguous and should give conditions and terms of the contract in such a way that purchase happens in a systematic way by the zonal railways. So, what is a purchase order? Who places this purchase order? The purchase order is placed by stores officer. Purchased by stores officer, vetted by the stores accounts officer. Please remember, items of purchase orders, unless until they are under the powers of direct purchases, have to be vetted by the stores finance officer, but signed by the stores officer with the various details for the purchase of items from a supplier. That is the importance of the purchase order. Then what is a rate contract? I will give you few more items only, then we'll go into the subject. Rate contract is a contract under which during the period of its currency, the contractor engages to supply materials on demand. The contractor engages to supply materials on demand irrespective of the quantity at fixed unit rates or prices within a given period of the receipt of such demand. So normally, these kind of contracts are placed whenever we don't know, we are not certain about the quantity to be taken. Normally, rate contracts are more suitable for the medical items, wherever diseases like cancer, like things there, that can, this rate contract can be useful, because this rate contract can be given for a particular 1 year, maybe 2 year, covering one zonal railway, maybe 2-3 zonal railways, one division, maybe 3-4 divisions, will have case abhi kar sakte. So it is a rate contract is an important tool of instrument where we can have some kind of benefit for the purchasers, for the items which can be clubbed in a group. Thereby, rate contract is beneficial wherever these quantities are not certain, the quantities of procurement are not certain. Then running contract. The running contract is one under which during the period of its currency, the contractor engages to supply and the other party of the contract to take specified quantity within the variation, some percentage variation of material as and when ordered at fixed unit rates. The unit rate is fixed here or price within a given period of the receipt of such order. So normally, whenever the market fluctuations are very high, with reference to normally there is a tendency in the fluctuation in the market price like diesel oil, petrol, and oil lubricants they offer. In that case, we can have a running contract with the suppliers. As such, we can have a fixed rate so that our charge to the final heads will be uniform and activities expenditure is uniform. Thereby, railway will gain advantage of bulk purchase by entering into running contracts with percentage variation of quantity within that period, which is unacceptable for the both the parties. That is known as running contract. Schedule contracts means our ordinary jaisa contract hai, we use in this schedule contract, we know the specific quantity fixed for that period, we know the annual indents, we know the annual consumption. Easily, in this specific schedule contract, we have a specified quantity to be supplied within a given period at fixed rates of price for each various items comprising of such work or supply. So, it is a schedule contract. Normally, we go for this contract. So, this is a model of contract. Normally, Indian Railways is the schedule contract model. In this, the sum he is to receive, normally the supplier he is to receive is depending upon the actual quantities he has supplied or the work done he has done, that the supply specification, everything is clearly written. So it is known as a schedule contract. It is a normal format of contract generally used in IR for regular supplies to the activities. So please remember, sir, rate contract, running contract, schedule contract. Examination ka question hai, short answer mein aa sakta hai. A most important thing, rate contract, running contract, or schedule contract. So most important, please पढ़ लो आप लोग, देन हम आएंगे ऑपरेशन का सस्पेंस अकाउंट्स। सो व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ ऑपरेशन ऑफ सस्पेंस अकाउंट इज टू सी दैट व्हेन वी डोंट नो, व्हेन वी डोंट नो द फाइनल हेड ऑफ एलोकेशन फॉर व्हिच दिस सप्लाई गोस। सो इन अ स्टोसी स्टॉक अकाउंट इट इज कैप्ट, वी डोंट नो व्हिच फाइनल हेड, इट मे बी रेवेन्यू डिमांड और इट मे बी ए प्लान हेड, वी डू नॉट नो unless until the consigns are identified for that particular item. The item is common both for the construction as well as the normal maintenance. Easily we operate this stock account, that is stores suspense account. Again, aur ek bar bataunga, the purpose of operation of a suspense head is to record the accounting transactions temporarily. Temporarily, to record the transactions temporarily for any reason, before clearing the same to the final heads. So after knowing the activity, after knowing the final allocation, we clear the suspense account, put it to the final heads. That is the purpose of operational suspense account. But hamara pass hai aur do teen suspense, char panch suspense heads hai. So we take what is these things. In these transactions, normally any stores, any transactions suspense account will be recorded clearly. It should be recorded clearly. That is voucher number, allocation, sanction, etc. Oh, Mara. It should be ensured that no item become inefficient in a stores. More so, any item which are booked to this final head, that means there is no transaction related to that particular item. That should not happen. It should not become an irregular item. For want of details, they should not. So all details must be correctly recorded in this suspense account. To identify for the purpose of review and as well as for the purpose of correct charge whenever it is issued to a particular activity. So this is important. So easily, accounts officers are responsible for reviewing the suspense balances, any suspense balances. So hamara responsibility hai accounts office ka ye review karna hai. A time frame action and the periodical review should be done by the accounts officer. See, even the stores accounts also, even stores suspense balance also, they are supposedly reviewed by the stores accounts officer attached to a particular stores depot. These guidelines are normally, the stores accounting and stores guidelines are normally applicable to all general railways. It is standard, and also the production units, also the production unit wherever we operate these suspense accounts. So that means so much standardization is available for the purpose of uniformity of the recording the transaction. For the purpose of recording the transactions uniformly and have standardization, we have this standard procedure for all the general railways and as well as the production units. So that is the importance of the operation of stores balances. But there is a, for every department, for every system of service, we have a performance parameter. For our stores ki bare mein, we have one performance parameter with reference to stores balances, that is known as turnover ratio. TOR bolta hai, iska naam kya hai? TOR. TOR means turnover ratio. What is this turnover ratio? Is closing balance of item, closing balance quantity, that is closing quantity or value of the item, closing value of that particular item divided with the total issues of that item. Leave nothing but turnover ratio. It may be for a single item, it may be for the group of items, it may be for the entire depot, or it may be for the entire general railway, or it may be for the entire Indian Railways as such. SRB kar sakte. So we can have a very in-detail turnover ratio analysis, a managerial way. ग्रुप वाइज कर सकते हैं, इवन आइटम वाइज भी कर सकते हैं, डिपो वाइज भी कर सकते हैं, डिपो डिपो भी कंपैरिजन भी कर सकते हैं टीओआर का एक आइटम का, इतना जांच करे हो सकते हैं बाय अराइविंग एट इन बाय नोइंग इट या टर्नओवर रेशियो। वेरी सिंपल है, वेरी सिंपल रेशियो है, दैट इज क्लोजिंग बैलेंस ऑफ द आइटम्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी वैल्यू, क्लोजिंग बैलेंस ऑफ द आइटम इन टर्म्स ऑफ वैल्यू डिवाइडेड बाय द टोटल इश्यूज ड्यूरिंग दैट ईयर इनटू 100, दैट मींस total inventory balance at the closing, total value of issues, that is credits in that item during the year into 100 is nothing but inventory turnover ratio. So kitna percent hona chahiye, what is the optimum percentage? So itna bada school of thought is, people say some maybe it is advantage to can have 10%, have 15%, but lekin it is desirable to have 9%. It is only desirable to have 9% because it is based on the parameters where we can today we have management information systems, various Samarapas management information systems type. See, our turnover ratio can be maintained in the single digit, maximum possible single digit at 9%. But however, today Indian Railways, we have a turnover ratio oscillating between 15% to 17% at present. Actually, it is between 15% to 16% is happening in Indian Railways. But however, it is desirable to have turnover ratio at 9%. It is, what is turnover ratio? A performance parameter of the stores department. This is a performance parameter of the stores department. What is the purpose? This is for analyzing the efficiency of the inventory management. This is for the purpose of analyzing the efficiency of the inventory management. So inventory management, A class items, B class items, C class items, group wise, depot wise, PL number wise, you can have any number of analysis with reference to this turnover ratio. So kaisa karenge, what is this tool, kaisa use karna hai control over expenditure mein. So set a target for each item, setting a target of PR in the stores budget for each item, maybe groups of items, maybe all groups of items, general purpose items, fuel items, anything for that matter, you can have a target, and with to achieve the target within that year, with the combined effort of user department ke effort hona chahiye, aur stores department or finance department, teenon milake you can achieve the turnover ratio set for the target for each item after a proper analysis hone ke baad ye set kar sakte, aur iska achieve karne ke liye what are the efforts we made combined together with the management information system available, that will give the overall expenditure control on materials for IR activities. For IR activities, this turnover ratio is one of the tool for the purpose of expenditure control for setting the targets as well as achieving the targets against the set targets by various reviews during the year. So that is the most important aspect of the turnover ratio. How jaage jayenge? And now I will explain the purpose of operation of store suspense heads and how it is important for the analysis and control over expenditure. Normally, all items which are brought to the stock, which are purchased are available in the stores in stock account. Stores in stock account is maintained under the capital suspense account P7100. P means capital, 7100 means plan head, and 60 is the stores in stock account. That is the allocation, detailed allocation with reference to stores in stock account. However, the stores in stock account is assisted with the other suspense accounts where their outstanding balance are also can be analyzed in the stores in stock account. What are those items? The other suspense accounts which are operated in line with the stores in stock account are assisting the stores in stock account in a way that is for the purpose of purchases, for the purpose of sales, for the purpose of adjustments, and for the purpose of stores in transit, that is transfer of stores from one depot to another. So easily the transactions, stores in stock account transactions can be further identified for the purpose of control over expenditure, for the purpose of avoiding losses, is assisted with another four suspense accounts known as purchases, sales, stores in transit, and stock adjustment. These are the four suspense accounts are part of the stores in stock account, which are important for the purpose of accounting the transactions in a proper way to ensure that there is no inefficiency in the inventory management. That is important. Now I will discuss about the stores in stock account. What is the stores in stock account for the purpose of review? It is a debit balance. Debit balance indicates the physical stock available in a depot. The stock depot balance available physically in a depot in terms of money value is nothing but stores in stock. So how this is affected? When the material received in a depot, when the material aaya depot mein, kya dena hai pehle? A receipt note issue karna hai. A receipt note issue karke item is booked to the stores stock account. Whenever the stores stock account is, when item is getting into the stores stock account, What is debit? Stores is stock account is. What debit comes in? इसका principle क्या है? What debit comes in? So debit balance. The material is available. When the material is issued to the final head account is debited. Stores in stock account is credited. Means for receiving the material, the voucher is received note. For issuing the material, the voucher is issue note. So issue note say mutabi stores in stock account is credited. When the material is received, receipt token mutabi stores in stock account is debited. That is how the stores in stock account is operated through these two vouchers, R note and issue note. Receipt note and issue note. When the material is received, stores in stock account is debited. When the material is issued, stores in stock account is credited. That is the importance of that. So main batayega bataya ha what is to be done in the stores in stock account. It is difficult to see that all transactions are counted through stores monthly summaries. Whenever I issue the material, that is should be reflected in the stores monthly summary. There should not be any leftover items. That means linking the various locations and also in the revenue ka, revenue mein har demand ka and plan head ka, so har consignee ka, so like that demands for we will be linking all these items to the locations wherever the material from. Normally the rate applicable when I issue the items is book average rate. So that means when I check this account, what I check can quantities without values any vouchers are there, values without quantities any items are there, minus values or quantities are there anyway, because now today IMMS has come, there are no much issues related to these accounts. IMMS and IPAS we are maintaining. So in a way normally such kind of clerical mistakes are not happening, but anyway this is the responsibility, this is the items to be very reviewed in the accounts office. Normally just look at it when the transactions would be like this, when material are received and accounted through R note, stores in stock account is debited. When the material is issued, respective final head is debited, stores in stock account is credited. Now that means stores in stock account is a debit head of account. Debit when stores are received, credit when stores are issued. A debit balance suspense head of accounts, that is important thing here. So when a debit balance suspense account means it represents the quantities, it represents the true value of the items available in the stores depot. इसीलिए हम देख सकते हैं. So इसके लिए what are the tools available हमारे पास क्या है for review करने के लिए? एक transaction register, numerical ledger, some bin card, physical quantity करने के लिए. Normally general books and price ledger are reconciled in such a way there is no variation. Now under material management information, IMMS and also IPAS, now the accounted, there is no much gap for the purpose of adjustments in this chapter, in the reconciliation part. That is about the stores in stock account. The purpose of having the stores in stock account, the objective kya hota hai stores in stock account ka, iska closing balance should reflect the true and fair value. Iska closing balance stores account, stores stock account should represent true and fair value. True and fair value ka means closing balance should reflect the true value of the items which are available in the depots. That is right. Now our ek account, the purchase suspense account. The purchase suspense account mai bataya aapko pehle, when the material is received stores in stock account is debited. Ek aur ek credit hona chahiye, wo credit hai pehle, that is nothing but purchase suspense account. Now today kab kaisa hota hai payment, हमारा रेलवे का रूल क्या है? फर्स्ट रिसीव द मटेरियल, देन चेक द करेक्टनेस ऑफ द रिसीव एंड देन ओनली पे. दैट मींस व्हेन आई रिसीव द मटेरियल, मटेरियल इज रिसीव्ड इन द डिपो समवेयर एल्स, सो ए रिसीप्ट नोट इज इश्यू. ए रिसीप्ट नोट ऐड करके कंपनी करके परचेज ऑर्डर का रिफ्रेंस देके ही विल प्लेस ए बिल. द सप्लायर विल मेक ए क्लेम थ्रू ए बिल. द सप्लायर विल मेक ए क्लेम through a bill in the IREPS. Now it is in the IREPS only he is available. Now from IREPS it comes to IPAS or in the online payment. Bills are on stores, bills are online bills. Now we are paying the bills through online only. That means in the IREPS he is available, he can prefer a bill linking the R note for which he has given IMMS. Through IMMS or note is linked to the bill and then sent to the accounts office for payment. While making the payment, kaha hai iska janchkari? It is available against that PL number under purchase suspense account. Kaisa hai? It is available as a credit in the purchase suspense account. That particular item against the purchase order for that quantity is available in the purchase suspense account. So I pass me a link hone ke baad link hota hai. Once you give the purchase order number, automatically it gets linked. Or not is linked with the purchase order, and then immediately it is linked to the source stock account. Purchase suspense account is debited. When you pass the bill, checks and bills is credited. Malum hua na sir? Aur ek baar repeat karunga. When the material is received, source stock account is debited and credit is, and what is credited? Purchase suspense account is credited. When the bill is passed in IPAS, purchase suspense account is debited and checks and bills is credited. That is how the total transaction gets nullified and purchase suspense account gets closed. Purchase suspense account gets closed by paying the liability. So that means at any given date, purchase suspense always shows a credit balance. Purchase suspense always shows a credit balance. So the importance of posting of debits, importance of posting of credits, clearing the suspense, SCA review, monthly or quarterly or half yearly review, and also items. Now today they are all available on the online. So we have a data IAM module and Oracle database. Automatically items are getting linked. So normally we don't have any inefficient balances. We don't have any inefficient balance as on date, except for the legacy data, purana data ke bare mein. All items are current. Now the purchase suspense gets automatically linked in the IMMS and IPAS for enabling. It means at any given point of time, the purchase suspense account shows a credit balance. That means to that extent, the liability of the railways is to pay the bills. Outstanding liability of the railways to pay the bills. क्या दिखाता है purchase suspense? हमारा liability क्या है? हमारा लाइबिलिटी इतना आउटस्टैंडिंग बिल्स है हमारे पास. सो दैट इज द इंपॉर्टेंट आइटम फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ परचेस सस्पेंस एंड रिव्यू बाय परचेस सस्पेंस बाय अकाउंट्स ऑफिसर इज नेसेसरी. सो मैं थोड़ा नोट्स दिया है परचेस सस्पेंस के बारे में, क्या 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 होना चाहिए, पोस्टिंग ऑफ डेबिट्स, पोस्टिंग ऑफ क्रेडिट्स के बारे में, आइटम वाइज कैसा होना, ये मैं प्लीज रीड अफ्टरवर्ड्स. दैट मीन्स अगेन और एक बार रिपीट करूंगा. It is a credit based balance. When the SIP note is received by contra debit to source stock account, debit when stores bill passed or stores debits received from other units. Difference is cleared through any differences by not doing anything, by updating the rates can be done through receipt order adjustments. And the outstanding amount under purchase suspense indicates the liability of the railways for the payment to be made to the suppliers at the end of that particular month. It should not be more than 3 months old, 3 months. Nobody will keep quiet for taking the money. So for claiming the bills, so one should be very careful about this is a fraud prone area. Then there is another account known as sales suspense account. This is also part of the stores stock account, outstanding part of the stores stock account. This is nothing but whenever we make sales, this suspense account is opposite to the purchase suspense account, but in operation. But however, this also shows a credit balance. So sales suspense account is also showing an outstanding credit balance only, like purchase suspense. Purchase suspense is also outstanding credit. Sales suspense also shows outstanding credit only, because hamara sales mein kya hota hai, hum pehle paisa receive karenge, baad mein hum pay karenge. Second treatment in purchase suspense is, there is a question. That means pehle stores in stock account debtor, purchase suspense account is credited. Second treatment hai, when bill is passed, purchase suspense account is debited, checks and bills is credited. Aisa hai na, purchase suspense nullify hota hai. That is the importance of operating a purchase suspense. So outstanding balance of the purchase suspense indicate the liability on the part of the railways to be payable to the suppliers. Aisa hai. That is the importance of परचेज सस्पेंस, सेल्स सस्पेंस के बारे में ये ऑपोजिट है परचेज सस्पेंस का, ये भी क्रेडिट बैलेंस होता है। क्यों बोले तो पहले हमारा रेलवे में फर्स्ट वी रिसीव द पेमेंट देन ओनली गिव द मटेरियल, सो फर्स्ट एक्शन विल बी रिसीविंग द एंटायर अमाउंट देन ओनली वी पे द रिसीव इश्यू द मटेरियल। सो नॉर्मली व्हेन वी इश्यू द मटेरियल वी विल इश्यू डिलीवरी इश्यू नोट बोलता है, हमारा सेल्स का ट्रांजैक्शन का इश्यू नोट क्या है, इट इज डिलीवरी इश्यू नोट। व्हेनेवर ए बिडर नॉर्मली वी रिसीव द एंटायर मनी when there is an auction takes place for the entire transaction, and in case of EMD also balance EMD and balance sale value pura mila ke pura money hamara kitty mein aana, at that time what is to be done, remittance into bank account debtor, that is when we receive the money what do we operate, remit RIB account, remittances into bank account debtor to sales suspense, pehle hum sales suspense create hona, ek suspense ka account operate karna zaruri hai to record the sales transactions. All the sales transactions have to be recorded through a sales suspense. So it is opposite of purchase suspense. It also shows credit balance. So remittance into bank account data to sales suspense. So what is happening when issue note is given? Say delivery issue note is given. But normally, are you? So sales suspense account normally other things remain on this issue note for having delivered the material. So then at the time whenever what we will do, we will deliver the material. When we deliver the material, so what is to be credited, what goes out, stock goes out. So stores in stock account should be credited, should be given a proper credit. Yes, it has given its proper credit, and sales suspense account is debited. Sales suspense account, that's why सेल्स सस्पेंस अकाउंट गेट्स नलीफाइड। तो मैं पहले क्या आना, पहले कैश आना और बाद में डिलीवरी नोट देना, डिलीवरी इश्यू नोट बोलते हैं, डिलीवरी इश्यू नोट। सो दैट मीन्स इट रिप्रेजेंट्स क्रेडिट बैलेंस, इट हैज टू पार्ट्स, 71 crore सेल्स अदर देन पीएल, 7150 सेल्स फेयर और ऑपरेट थ्रू सस्पेंस अकाउंट। सो sales through, that means nowadays all online payments only, so it is getting linked to the online transactions. Normally it is heavy to see that sales have been made under the competent authority and that proper departmental charges have been added to the booked prices wherever necessary. Wherever necessary we have to add departmental charges. All debit items are current and the details are recorded so that claims can be made if necessary, there are no irregular items. That is about the operation of sales suspense account. So what is importance here in sales account, sales suspense account? What is the credit balance indicates sales suspense account? It is the liability of the railways to issue the material, that is the money yet to be received. Otherwise we can say the money yet to be received, the means item delivery we have given idea, because delivery issue note one why we will not give, we have yet to issue the material by through account the material through a delivery sale issue note, delivery issue note is there whenever I give a delivery issue note. So that is most important thing. This credit balance indicates the outstanding liability on the part of the railways to issue the materials to the suppliers for which amounts are yet to be accounted for or accounted to be received, dono ho sakta hai. So that is the importance of the sales suspense. Is her many source accounts officer is responsible to review. Then there is another account known as stores in transit account. It represents balance. Normally, this represents the balance at the receiving depot. When the material is received, normally when the material issued, it is transferred. It is based on the urgency. Immediately, material activity ki dena chahiye. Normally, when I receive the material in the receiving depot, what I do, I will not be getting the total transaction. So first, I take the material, stores in stock account, set up to stores in transit account. Then, when I get the account, then stores in stock account I clear, and then normally stores material is issued to the final head. Final head account is deferred to stores in stock account is credited in the receiving. But what is outstanding in the receiving depot? Only SINT account will be getting outstanding in the report. In the SINT account, it gets only nullified only after punching of the report transfer issue notice punched the accountant through the source monthly summary. Normally that is because it is centralized accounting. So it is to be necessary between the depot transfers. There is no financial transaction. It is watching the transactions through the source monthly summaries on account of the SINT account. That means we operate minus debits and we operate minus credit among the depot transactions. The SINT account is maintained at the receiving depot only. Please remember, I repeat karunga mai ek baar. The SINT accounting is maintained receiving depot. That means her depot is a receiving depot for the items which they have received. So whenever a source account officer goes for a review, normally you look for the depot wise registers for the items which are outstanding beyond 1 month. There should not be any item in the SINT account outstanding more than 1 month. Normally more than 1 month is a, it should be settled. It should be settled because it is the same accounting. It is the same depot is, all depots are in one accounting unit. It is the stores accounting unit. So as such, it should be seen that minus debits and minus rates are properly linked in the stores in transit account. And P7170 is the allocation for the stores in transit account. So this is maintained at the receiving depot. It is maintained at the receiving depot only. So all the depots receive whenever they receive the material for their issues or their activities, then SINT account is operated. This is important. So मैं थोड़ा आपको सीक्वेंस के बारे में एक चार्ट बताया. प्लीज रिफर टू दिस चैप्टर चार्ट. देन देयर इज अनदर अकाउंट नोन एज स्टोर स्टॉक एडजस्टमेंट अकाउंट. व्हाट इज दिस स्टॉक एडजस्टमेंट अकाउंट? मैं आपको थोड़ा मटेरियल दे दूंगा. दिस सस्पेंस अकाउंट इज ऑपरेटेड फॉर रिकॉर्डिंग डिफरेंसेस नॉर्मली दिस इज 7180 एंड 7190 are the two locations normally we operate a stock adjustment account, P7180 and P7190. Normally the 7180 is the major item of account. This is operated for recording difference arising out of variations in stock. Please remember, variation hota hai in stock during departmental stock verification as well as account stock verification. अकाउंट स्टॉक वेरिफिकेशन में हो सकता है और डिपार्टमेंट स्टॉक वेरिफिकेशन भी हो सकता है. सो दिस इज वेरिएशन इन स्टॉक. लॉस ऑफ और एक्सेस ऑफ स्टॉक अवेलेबल द डिपो इज बुक्ड अंडर दिस ट्रांजैक्शन. देन वेरिएशन इन प्राइस ऑफ स्टॉक ड्यू टू चेंज इन प्राइस ऑफ द मींस वेरिएशन इन स्टॉक एंड वेरिएशन प्राइस इज एक आइटम हो सकता है. इन प्राइस ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स परचेज्ड फ्रॉम मार्केट देयर मे बी वेरिएशंस. सो देयर मे बी ना receipt order adjustment, इसीलिए ये भी हो सकता है. Then change in price of products manufactured in workshop. In a workshop, normally whenever a cost accountant will give a rate, there may be a supplementary rate may be given by him due to escalation in price during the manufacturing operations. In such cases also, the variation in price, which are the items which are manufactured in the company, is also booked to this item. Then difference in book value and actual value realized in scrap value. Normally when I issue a DSI to giving it to the final heads, credits outside the scope of the demand in for the revenue operations. In such case, I operate only book average rate of the scrap item. But however, if the realization more than this the book average rate, then I have to upgrade the rate as well. That difference I have to book to the some stock adjustment account. So stock adjustment account takes the differences minus difference and plus difference also. Anyway, minus this way losses and also gains out of sales, losses out of sales, or maybe variations, anything it will take stock adjustment account. So stock adjustment account is such an important thing. So difference in book value and VAT actual value realized on scrap sales. Normally this is a major, so many items, so many vouchers will be there in this, on this account. Then miscellaneous items also we can book under the stock adjustment account. There are differences due to loss, theft, obsolescence, maybe due to design change, etc. And miscellaneous causes, loss on account of classification of new material as second hand. Sometimes due to policy change, we identify them those items not to use and mail them. So it become a second hand item. So we have to use somewhere else only, not as a mainline item, because that may deviate. Loss on account, rounding off rupee is paise, value brought on books through depots, stock sheets, pending receipt of vouchers. Sometimes vouchers are not available, but there are some kind of stock sheets outstanding. So such items are also brought under the stock adjustment account. So please remember, all of you, what are the items that are recorded in the stock adjustment account? It is value, variation in the stock, variation in price, dono. Then difference in book value and actual value, like in the scrap value, and then miscellaneous causes. These are the various causes. These causes. So this expense account normally stock adjustment account. Normally, stock adjustment represents the difference in value, then difference between price ranges in general books and miscellaneous items. So these are the major three parts we can operate under P71AD, for which I have further detail. Please read and take this and read. Normally, when as an accounts officer, when we do these postings, the debits and credits in this account are posted separately and reconciled regularly. So as to ensure that balance under this suspense account is kept every 6 months. So there should not be any item outstanding related to the stock adjustment account beyond 6 months. If it is going beyond 6 months, we have to provide the reasons for the not clearing this account to the final heads and the GM shop to hum explanation dena hai. So normally any items which are of no use, they are no use for the purpose of keeping in stock adjustment account, we have to be give to the final heads invariable by the stores accounts officer by monthly review. It is necessary that at the quarterly intervals that there is no outstanding item under the stock adjustment account unless until it has a reason to maintain. So no item outstanding may hona chahiye beyond 3 months. That is the importance of the stock adjustment accounting postings. In case items not cleared in that particular quarter, unless it is established by advanced inquiry that there is a possibility of their clearance the next month or two, should be reported to general manager. So aapka explanation dena hai GM sir ka. So it goes to GM's notice. So it is so important that all items in the stock adjustment accounting postings beyond 3 months have to be reasonably recorded, reasons to be recorded, and also apprised to the general manager sir. But as a rule, all the items under stock adjustment account with duly recorded grievance have to be cleared off to the final heads every quarterly a must item. So now under IMS is in operation now. The transfer is supporting the SMS. So when we analyze the stores monthly summary, SMS means stores monthly summaries, to clear the items by JVs and a monthly basis, now it is available. And also it provides, IMS provides the source of clearance. So how to clear, also it will provide us, guide us in the petty items and the various classification of items. So with that, normally by taking the approval of the account authority, we can clear these items based on the MSOP powers available. Items of value or items of retention of the same in stock account adjustment account beyond permissible books are required to be cleared to finance within 2 or 3 months with the approval of AGM. Again, it is not possible within the competence of the accounts office to clear. Yes, apprised regions are take approval and then clear. So a half yearly review is there for these items at the end of 30th September and as well as in the 31st December. So 31st September and 31st December, normally by 31st March, the balance in themselves we have been explaining in various budgetary financial reviews. But however, these two half years, that is ending 30th September, 6 months ending 30th September and 6 months ending 31st December are crucial, where the report to the general manager's office has to be done of the non-clearance of items and action to be taken for the clearance of stock adjustment items to the final heads. So that is about the clearance of stock adjustment account. MAR account is nothing but working expenses. It is related to normally it is a debit balance, miscellaneous advances and revenue account, working expense. Whenever we have to make under special circumstances, whenever we have to make advance payments for the purchase of stores, purchase of materials, this head is operated. Normally, for local purchase of stores, whenever, unless until you give the check, they will not give the material. Some of the suppliers are like that. So when it is necessary, we have to do that. But operation of this MAR account, working expenses, should be seen that We know the final head, but still we have to make advance payments. In such cases, proof of and we have to pay, and then sufficient documentary evidence available to trace the transaction to support the recovery and adjustment in case of a untraceable item under this MAR account cutting expenses. Normally, the entries are to be conformity with what is not charges where the allocations are not known. Advances recoverable through cash or adjustment. We have given the money, but still the payment has not been, the supply has not been made by the supplier for the reasons to be recorded. Interdepartmental transaction waiting acceptance with other departments like that. So these are all the items outstanding in the MAR working as miscellaneous advances revenue account, where which we have made advance payments for which supplies yet to be received, for which supplies yet to be achieved. For those items, review kya hota hai? So all our efforts are made to minimize the suspense balance and all suspense balance are subject to half yearly review. All these balances under half yearly review at FNC level and also at board level. The regular items more than 1 year old balance are subject to scrutiny and required to be followed with the HODs of concerned departments. Items outstanding with regard to the wherever the departmental HOD is responsible for outstanding that item in any of these suspense accounts, including the MAR account, should be brought out for the corrective action within that one. That is how the operation of suspense accounts is part of the control over expenditure mechanism. But however, as a part of the financial control over stores expenditure, क्या होना चाहिए हमारा broadly क्या है ये financial control, क्या क्या चीज है इसमें हमारा activity है accounts का as internal check managers, finance managers, what we do, we broadly the financial control of stores expenditure कैसा कर सकते हैं एक बार देखेंगे birds eye view while scrutinizing the stock indents and non-stock indents at the time of before entering into the liabilities itself we have to scrutinize the stock indents and non-stock indents. Similarly, while awarding the contracts or supplier stores and avail the advantage of bulk purchase. At that time also, we have to ensure that awarding the contract itself, whether we are doing it with a reasonable way. Controlling the expenditure before incurring the liability itself by watching the indents and purchase orders through a funds register. A tool hai hamara paas, a funds mein pehle slide mein bataya, important tool hai funds register. A funds register hona chahiye har accounts department mein to record the liabilities on account of indents, similarly on account of purchase orders issued against each group of material against the budget grant available. So that is for the purpose of budgetary control as well as the expenditure control before incurring the liability itself. Similarly, internal check of stores drawers. क्या करना while issuing the material to the activities when I am issuing the material to a particular activity, a particular consignee, whether that consignee is responsible to take that material from the stock has to be seen. That is, your store's monthly summaries are supposed to be checked internally for the purpose of quantity of material drawn by the consignees as well as the activity that is linked to the act, whether they are drawing the material based on the activity. So for example, a paint shop consignee cannot draw material on account of wheels. SSCPV should not draw the mechanical items like that. It should be seen that way. So regular verification of stock, normally a system should also be there for the regular verification of stock by departmental officers as well as the accounts office department. So accounts stock verifiers as well as departmental stock verifiers should verify. The system should verify. There should be a check, a counter check for checks and balances. Normally again now today we have MIS is there, Management Information System. Now today the linking IMMS, Integrated Material Management Information System. Now this, due to this IMMS, we all have user depot modules have been connected. Any user depot department module has been connected with the drawal of material. So now the online requisition is taking place. We can avoid having buffer stocks. So we can avoid excess procurement and loss on account of that. So like that, this is the overall financial control of stores expenditure is done at various stages. At various stages. One means at the time of scrutinizing dividends and purchase orders, for non-stock items and non-stock items like that, having a funds register, internal check of SMS, and having stock verification, and also link the items to avoid bulk buffer stocks for restocking the items. So as the role of accounts department, it is to check the financial transactions of stores to ascertain that the departmental regulations, normally whenever we do so, whether the department regulations and governing purchases, receipts and issues are followed. Receipts, issues and custody of these items are followed. And while doing the condemnation, and while making, while sales through auctions, while stock taking, whether we have done all these activities in a proper systematic manner, whether we have done or not, it is the part of the financial control over stores expenditure. Unless until combined effort we made for the purpose of these, having the stocks not in excess procurement as well as proper issue and proper control and proper balance inventory at the end, this is the role of accounts department to assist with that. Then I will say, what is that you do while drawing the stores draws? Now it is mechanized. Now all the material draws are through S13, that is the document through which the material is drawn is S13. Normally stores monthly summaries are linked to each voucher. Now the mechanized, now the IMMS provides the entire data with reference to each item. So the part of internal check is now more on online. So it is, stores draws are subject to internal check. Stores draws are subject to internal check. See that the items are drawn proportionately with reference to activity and also as such required by the activities. That is the importance of the verifying the draws. Before draw of material itself to the particular consignment, what is governing them for the purpose of cost control for the items? Well, we making this scrutiny of indents, whether we are making unnecessary purchase just based on the issue. It means unnecessary purchase ke mutabik kya hai, just hum issue kiya hai isliye aur indent base karenge, aisa nahi hai. So it should be based on the continuance of activity. That means materials and space to be decided upon the loco, carriage, wagon holdings of depot, shed, workshop shed open line hota hai, depot open line hota hai, workshop mein hota hai. So quantity per each loco, per carriage, per wagon, also for that particular activity going to be scheduled as a POH or intermittent overhauling, and periodicity of change of items, any such, all those things have to be seen before agreeing to the indent itself, whether it is an annual indent or maybe a particular for that purpose indent is non-stock indent. So frequency of change of item, kab change karna hai IOH mein, POH mein kab change karna hai, these are all, these will decide the average annual consumption. These will decide the average annual consumption of the items. So shelf life of item and percentage of rejection, consumption pattern based on the age cum condition of rolling stock, what is a must change item, what are the must change items, where they would procured, what is the cost of those items, how do we regulate that, safety, it's a safety item, reliability of the source of supply to be ensured. These are all the various items, and also whenever the some items get released, one to one account has to honor them. So whenever these things are doing, also the indents or the documents whatever are faced are signed by the competent authority and is also concerned with the user department. User department role is also important. So also it is to be ensured that rolling components, normally whenever we identify these items, say PL number, normally a group, a committee approves the items under A category, B category items, C category items. A category items are subject to vetting by associate accounts office. B category items are subject to vetting by associate accounts office whenever their consumption is more than 10% of the last year's consumption. C category items, of course, no vetting is required for those items. So like that, we have a system of control with reference to procurement of items, also having the system of not delaying the procurement process, not delaying the procurement process. That is the, what is the ideal way of procuring, an ideal way of procurement to avoid excess stocks by railway is a balancing factor. Normally the funds register may have thoda bahut thoda ye de diya mai funds register ke bare mein certification of funds is zarurat hai. Kaun maintain karega isko funds register? It is now under IMMS. It is maintained in the accounts office. So stores finance officer is to watch the incurrence of liabilities against the budget grant allotted for each group of stores. Each group of stores may there are area is upper low. This is most important item for our examination point of view. So hum ab dekh lo aur ek baar padh lo. So amount of each contract or indent forming a charge against the year's allotment is a saal ka allotment mein har cheez हर ग्रुप का आइटम हर ग्रुप का कितना होता है अप्रोप्रिएट ऑफ स्टोर्स व्हाट इज द ग्रांट अवेलेबल व्हाट इज द लायबिलिटी मेड व्हाट इज द ग्रांट अवेलेबल व्हाट इज द लायबिलिटी मेड एनी चेंजेस आर टू बी मेड चेंजेस इन द एक्टिविटी ड्यूरिंग सम टाइम्स व्हाट हैपन वी आर विथड्रॉइंग द डीजल लोकोस रिप्लेसिंग देम विद द इलेक्ट्रिक लोकोस सो ग्रुप ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक लोको आइटम शुड कम डाउन डीजल लोको आइटम शुड कम डाउन इलेक्ट्रिक लोको आइटम शुड गो अप लाइक दैट वी हैव टू हैव the proper internal control mechanism with reference to placing of indents based on the requirement of activities accordingly. As such, a financial review is to be done by the associate finance officer for the monthly progress of expenditure at the procurement stage itself. So a fund register is an important tool for the purpose of control over expenditure mechanism control or expenditure mechanism. Funds register is an important tool wherein which the associate finance officer for the monthly progress of the expenditure at the procurement stage itself before incurring the liability should be seen and reviewed and also mentioned. Then processing of stock items, how the stock items and annual estimates, ANEs, Boleto annual estimates. So normally when we make an annual estimates, normally this is for the purpose of availing the advantage of bulk purchase. So quantity is to be decided for both for the open line and also workshops. Each depot, all combining the all depots or group of depots having similar activities like that. When we make purchases for the purpose of general purchases of stores budget, we will have a system of having the processing of stock and indents and vetting the stock and indents by the associate accounts officer to see that, and it also review that the quantities under each item are correlated with the activities proposed for that particular financial year, for that particular financial year. ये देखना है, आप देख लो. So this is important. So most important thing is the having the process of सिमिलरली नॉन स्टॉक आइटम्स इन द नॉन स्टॉक आइटम्स के बारे में क्या होता है सो डायरेक्टली दी यूजर डिपार्टमेंट इज द कन्वीनर फॉर द प्रोक्योरमेंट यूजर डिपार्टमेंट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मेकिंग द इवेंट बट स्टोर्स ऑफिसर इज एसोसिएटिंग द परचेज फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ एक्सपर्टाइज का परचेज एक्सपर्टाइज करने के लिए इसका होता है हमारा फाइनेंस ऑफिसर सभी जगह में होता है सो लाइक दैट व्हेन वी आर डूइंग नॉन स्टॉक इवेंट्स नॉर्मली नॉन स्टॉक बजट कहाँ होता है रेवेन्यू के बारे में रेवेन्यू प्राइमरी यूनिट है 28 में होता है अरे कैपिटल प्राइमरी यूनिट में हल प्लान हेड का प्राइमरी यूनिट 04 में होता है 05 प्राइमरी यूनिट अंडर कैपिटल इज मटेरियल ड्रॉन फ्रॉम स्टॉक हियर पीयू 27 है सो वन हैज टू बी वेरी केयरफुल द प्लेसिंग ऑफ आइटम्स बिटवीन द पीयू 27 एंड पीयू 24 27 एंड 28 इन द रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर के बारे में एंड पीयू 04 एंड पीयू 5 इन द केस ऑफ प्लानिट एक्सपेंडिचर के बारे में सब देखना चाहिए वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्लैरिटी देखना है आइटम्स नॉट बी गेट रिपीटेड बिटवीन दीज टू सो कॉस्ट ऑफ द आइटम्स आर डायरेक्टली चार्ज टू द फाइनल हेड्स व्हेनेवर दीज व्हेनेवर बाइंग दीज आइटम्स नॉन स्टॉक इंडेंट्स लास्ट परचेज डेट्स आर द बेसिस फॉर प्रोसेसिंग द एनएस इंडेंट्स यस देन वी शुड नॉट टेक बुक एवरेज डेट हियर हियर वी हैव टू लास्ट परचेज डेट ओनली वी हैव टू टेक बिकॉज़ नॉन स्टॉक इंडेंट इज ओनली फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ बाय डायरेक्ट परचेज So here, when we liability register again for these items also has to be maintained. Liability register for the stock items. Similarly, liability register for the non-stock items also. So liability register for non-stock items is maintained in the executive departments. liability register and stock item is maintained in the stores accounts office. Please remember. Please remember. But लेकिन non-stock Indians liability register के बारे में हम भी इसका check करेंगे. हमारा ये register में हम ही हम इन हम accounts office हम railways पे practice क्या 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 है बोले तो ये non-stock Indians liability register also maintained in the accounts department. So you have to watch. So whenever items are entered in the liability list of non-stock items, then इसका प्रोग्रेस भी वॉच करना चाहिए अगेंस्ट द बजट ग्रांट मेड अवेलेबल टू दैट मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. सो जनरली ऑल नॉर्मली स्टॉक आइटम्स ड्यू टू एडवांस एक्शन वी कैन गो टू द 15 मंथ्स कंसम्पशन आल्सो बिकॉज़ ऑफ लीड टाइम. ईट टाइम हो बट लेकिन नॉन स्टॉक के बारे में क्या होना चाहिए, ऑल नॉन स्टॉक आइटम्स आर फॉर द करंट ऑपरेटिंग पीरियड दैट इज ए बजट ग्रांट का साल में होना, ए फाइनेंशियल ईयर, ए फाइनेंशियल ईयर देख के करना है. सो नॉन स्टॉक आइटम्स ऑल इंडियंस आर रेगुलेटेड टू द बजट ग्रांट अवेलेबल फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर फाइनेंशियल ईयर, फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर फाइनेंशियल ईयर. वेयर एज स्टॉक आइटम्स स्पिल हो सकते हैं आगे साल का, बिकॉज इसीलिए स्टोर्स इन स्टॉक अकाउंट सस्पेंस अकाउंट है. इसीलिए वी हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल बिटवीन लिवरेज बिटवीन मेंटेन होना चाहिए बिटवीन द स्टॉक आइटम्स इंडेंट्स एंड नॉन स्टॉक आइटम इंडेंट्स. देयर बाय we will be associating for the purchase of these items. So friends, our final head of account is miscellaneous advances capital account. Normally this is a corresponding entry in the sources stock account. Normally we will be seeing this whenever I purchase items, whenever I make mobilization advance or any such things, I will be using this account, plan 7300. When I issue the material for the purpose of fabrication key, ये अकाउंट में यूज करूंगा. सो बोथ सोर्सेस ऑफ अकाउंट डेबिट्स एंड क्रेडिट्स आर गेट वॉचिंग थ्रू दिस अकाउंट अंडर दिस 7300 इज थ्रू अगेन सोर्सेस स्टॉक अकाउंट ओनली. सो मिसलेनियस एडवांसेस कैपिटल अकाउंट व्हिच इज ए प्लान हेड इज पी 7300 व्हिच इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट आइटम. नॉर्मली व्हेन वी यूज दिस सस्पेंस हेड अकाउंट अंडर मोबिलाइजेशन एडवांसेस एंड ऑल्सो फॉर द आइटम्स व्हिच आर इश्यूड टू द फैब्रिकेशन. For example, tunnel boring machines, big, bada machines, carry raw material hona chahiye. So for this purpose, we issue the items, raw material to the fabricator. The fabricator will make the machine and give it back to us. And then the difference between the cost of the material supplied and the cost of the final product received is nothing but charges related to fabrication charges. So normally, normally credit will be more than the debit. That same is the liability on the payment of the payment to be made to the fabricating contractor. That is how the watching of miscellaneous advances capital account happens in Indian Railway stores accounting principles. So in the control over expenditure mechanism broadly mein hum kya discuss kiya, financial control ki a slide hai pura guiding slide. And while scrutinizing the stock indents, non-stock indents, what kya hona chahiye? While awarding the contract for supply of stores and avail advantage of bulk purchase, kya hona chahiye? Controlling the expenditure before including the liabilities, kya tools hona chahiye hamare paas? Funds register for better budgetary control, both for stock and non-stock. Then internal check of track stores also by associate account services on SMS monthly, that is done. System now, some places may be manually ho sakta hai. Then verification stock by both departments and also account stock prepared to identify the losses and identify the buffer stocks and linking the MIS management information systems like IREPS, IMMS, and IPAS in such a way that procurement, receipt, issue, accountal, and closing balance are properly regulated through the management information system by avoiding buffer stocks and to ensure there is a continuous material available to the activities. So role of accounts officer from all these aspects is to check the financial transaction of stores as a timely departmental regulation. So by doing so, kya hamara ask kya hai suvidha kya hai bol do hamara regulations governing for rules related to purchases, receipts, issues, custody and condemnation ka rules alag hai, sales ka rules alag hai, stock taking properly carried out to ensure that there is a system of and expenditure control in the stores transactions. That is how expenditure control is done in the is assisted by the finance and accounts department of the stores accounts office. So friends, with that I will be closing this session with this takeaway to all of you. I also gave you some short answer questions, five slides. Please, all of you, answer these questions sincerely, honestly. Please don't look at what the key. Key is available at the end. Please look at this key also there here, no? But don't look at this beginning itself. Please sincerely, honestly attend the short answer questions all by me. It is a self-examination for you. I'm giving a self-examination of five slides. Please download all the five slides, write answers, and correct the answers with the key available at the end of this, and ensure that you correct yourself by learning by yourself. This is what, friends, I am leaving with you. And also, I just gave what is an NXLJ and misclassification, what is meant by misclassification for the transactions, where they happen, and it is a schedule to appropriation accounts, misclassification, that is known as NXLJ, which is a prominent item by the audit department, which represents misclassification of items in accounts. In particular, stores transactions, any expenditure or income wrongly shown in one head of account instead of correct head account is known as misclassification. That is a definition given that booking of expenditure in one source fund to another source fund, for example, non-clearing the items which is pertaining to the plan head, other plan head, maybe 7300, which remains in the 7100 is a misclassification. Similarly, between 71 to 7200 is a misclassification. So that is one plan head to other plan head. Similarly, one source fund to other source fund, BRF to capital. And similarly, expenditure and inventories list of revenue heads. Expenditure ought to have been sent to the revenue heads, which remained in the stores and stock account for the completed transactions is also a misclassification. These things can be avoided by reviewing the stock adjustment account, by reviewing these stores and stock account and various suspense accounts outstanding on a monthly basis by the associate account service. Normally, transactions you find between 27 to 30, 32, 27, 28 and 04 in the 4 to 05 in the case of planned expenditure. Like that, we are supposed to verify and check these transactions to avoid misclassification. Friends, with the takeaway, I am closing. Please, all of you, attempt these questions sincerely and honestly, and it is for your self-examination. Thank you for this day.
Sir,
I will ask questions.
Yeah, participants. Sir, can I unmute all the participants?
Oh, yes, please. All are welcome.
All are unmuted. You can ask the queries.
Yes. Friends,
sir, some queries in the chat box, sir. Please check, sir.
Queries in the chat box. Are these that time itself I have answered them, yeah?
Okay, sir.
That itself, at the time I have answered them.
Okay, sir.
No fresh questions are available. I please share this presentation to all our friends, because they are all every two to slides can be a short answer question in the examination, and maybe some are there for the self examination topics for the at the end for them. They have to see all the boys. Please attempt the questions sincerely and then correct yourself. Okay, anything, please come back to me through Nagesh Rao.
Sir, I hope no queries from the participants, sir.
Okay, Naina, thank you.
Yeah, thank you, sir. On behalf of the academy, I thank faculty Sri P.V. Ragaragaru for a nice coverage of our entire this store suspenses and related expenditure control. Thank you. Remaining tomorrow session, the login time is 2:45 p.m. and the session time is 3 to 4:45. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you, Nagesh Rao. Thank you very much. Thank you, friends.